it really appears that we're not going to be able to design all of our UFAs at this point. This was something that we have talked with Philip and his agent Alan Walsh for quite a time here, and I think although that we had his rights for another year, I think this was important for our team, and knowing his contract number leading forward, and also a younger defenseman on the right side that we feel that we can continue to work with, and I think there is more to come there. So it definitely was important for us to get Philip locked up here, and when he expressed his interest of wanted to stay in Vancouver and be part of this group for long term, we were extremely pleased to get it over the finish line here.
Ian McIntyre, Sportsnet.
Hi, Patrik. I know that I can't remember your exact phrase, but you told us at the end of the season that there's a pecking order that you have to work through. Like there's a, you know, a list of your free agents. I'm wondering how high a priority Philip Hronek was. And now that you have him signed, could that lead to progress with some of your other free agents? You've got 9 UFAs, of course.
Yeah, hi, and it definitely was a pecking order for us. Philip being a restricted free agent here, which also means that he was one of the younger guys that we were needed to take care of, and obviously we felt comfortable doing an 8-year deal with Philip and his path moving forward. It's an ongoing conversation with the UFAs, but they definitely appear to us here that we're not going to be able to sign all of them.
Patrik Johnston, Post Media.
Hey, Patrik, congratulations as well. Looking at the number, at the structure, you mentioned 8 years, you've got 8 years. You know, how did you come to 7.25 being an AAV? How did you come to 8 years? What was the thinking in all this? What were the comparables? Maybe you were looking at these kinds of things.
Well, I think that when you start a negotiation or a conversation with Philip and his agent, I think that was a preference from their end to stay in Vancouver for long term. And then obviously we as an organization need to look at our projected roster moving forward here, but we felt comfortable with age where Philip is and where we believe his game could go at. And also the finding a right shot defenseman at that age and his quality made us feel comfortable going to 8 year, and obviously it's two sides that it needs to work with the AAV, and that's why sometimes discussions or negotiations take a little bit longer.
Jeff Patterson, Rinkwide.
Hi, Patrik. Philip didn't want to talk about it at the exit meeting day, but was he hampered by something in the second half of the season, or how do you describe sort of the drop in production level from the start of the year to what we saw down the stretch in the playoffs?
Well, I think every player, when you play as long as we did this year, I think you're going through some bumps and bruises. And I, to be quite honest with you, I don't think our team in general was as productive offensively as we were the first half. That being said, I do think there is part of Philip's game where we can utilize him more offensively. If that's by having him with Quinn Hughes or having him running in another pair, being the main guy, how you utilize him on the power play. But I do think that this was a great experience and learning experience for Philip, playing those meaningful games in the end, getting those 13 playoff games. So I believe that He has another level to get to, and I believe that he's capable of getting to another level and finding his consistency more. I think he's a very competitive player, skates well. I think he moves the puck well, and he is a guy that fits well in our dressing room here.
We'll take a follow-up from Ian McIntyre, Sportsnet.
I know that cost certainty is always a good thing for the teams to know what they're going to be paying down the road. But the NHL is going into what could be a historically inflationary period in the next 3 years with the salary cap going up and up and up. Do you think that makes it more important to have cost certainty like you do with this deal?
It definitely does. I think also that seems to be a preference from some of the players. I don't know what's the right way to do it. I definitely think when players are in Phillip's age, that obviously you're still fairly young in today's game when you get into those longer term deals. Absolutely, cost certainty in today's game, but also knowing that there is another level on each individual to get to makes it easier too.
And we have a final follow-up from Patrik Johnston, Post Media.
Patrik, you mentioned obviously you're not going to be able to re-sign all your free agents, but securing Phillip on the right side makes it clear what parts of your defense core looks like. Do you envision pursuing another right shot defenseman in free agency at this point?
I don't know. I guess we had about 2 weeks away. So it depends where the discussions goes here with our current group, and then we have to regroup and see what's available. I believe that we have Noah Juleson that is capable of playing in the top six. We have Cole McWard knocking on the door that had a really strong second half in Abbotsford that I hope is going to have a good summer and come in here and push for a roster spot as well. So we're talking internally here. I'm talking to Rick Tocchet and his coaching staff as well. So we're looking at all options.
Thanks for liking the video and subscribing.